Here we go for the first match of the night for this stream. Gnome versus Yin. Yin's pulling out the ZSS to start. So far, Gnome is definitely in the prime position here. Let's see how long that lasts. Starting to build, continue building it up. Using the spin out to force Yin off stage. Clever. And the super armor on it. Yep, it is going to eat the down air punish for that jab mash. It's a great mash jab. Like any other, it's very punishable if you continue it. Not going to take too much else to finish out. Yep, the down tilt will do the trick at the ledge. And then starting this next stock with the up smash. Interesting. Okay, there's a punish. Ooh, that was a good punish. Back air out against it. Trying to use the side B to beat it out. Does not work. Still struggling to finish out the stock. Ooh, that's going to hurt. It eats two up airs for that attempt at the stock. Back air finally does the trick. 49%? Not terrible. Still could be doable for Yin. Same time, Gnome's fully aware that they have the lead here and is just playing it slow from behind the safety of the Mecha Koopas and just using the side B a lot. Can Yin close the gap and force Gnome on the back foot? Does not seem like it, as Gnome is the one getting all the punishes. Ooh, this could be. Nope, not able to get anything off of that Burry. Ooh-hoo! I respect the attempt, but just didn't commit understood that it wasn't going to work in that situation. Was reading that he'd stay out, but the side B came in and allowed him to get the punish. Ooh, that was an expertly spaced cannonball. And Yin getting the back air call out on the side B to take the second stock, now having a solid lead. Yep, just needs to wait it out. Ooh, good punish on the spot dodge. Up air just barely does it. I was trying to go for further extensions with the up airs, but Gnome smartly mashed an aerial out. Yin just trying to play it safe from behind the Zares, but his lead is that's a big downbeat. Nope, no, not able to recover from that low. Game one to Yin. Gnome was definitely feeling the pressure there, though, and sometimes you just, especially when you find your back against the wall, you might find yourself prone to big mistakes like that. It happens, but it was just the first game. We still got potentially two more to go here. Counterpick to small battlefield, definitely a better stage, mostly just because CSS does have a little bit of the ladder combos, so less platforms for her to utilize them on is always a plus. Yin went for the infamous confirm into down B to just stuff out that stock at like 42%, but missed the confirm, unfortunately. Or is it? It's kind of a dumb. It's a very silly confirm that I wonder how they allowed it to be kept. Ooh, there, still not enough. Catches the up B on the recovery, but is gonna fall out due to the ledge grab. Going for the hardest punish there. Ooh, getting a simple up air. I feel like that could have been an up B punish, but I don't know for sure. Yin is using that down B a lot, which it is easily the Hirosuit Samus' best move. Yin just not able to finish out this first stock right now. Granted, that's kind of how it was the first game too, but not to this extent. Finally gets the up B edgeguard to finally close out the stock. At a 67% deficit, which is slightly more of a deficit than the last game at this position, though Yin still won, so it could happen. Not the way it's going right now, though. Ooh, there's a nair to get out of the up airs before they become too domineering. Yin at a dangerous percent. Ooh, and the ledge cheese, Yin falls for it. Get it, doing the infamous buffered air dodge and costing him the stock. But Yin is answering back hard here. Doesn't get the meteor hitbox, unfortunately. Now we'll see if this is another situation where Yin isn't able to take the stock until 175. Not going to be a great sign if that's the case. That's going to hurt. And put Yin in a really bad spot. Once again, Gnome with the expert and the upbeat not quite enough. Just the fact that he knows the spacing on that cannonball to attack the ledge, that should be the game. Yep, as I said, that's Rapid Jab's one of the best jabs in the game. It's fast. Not only does it have the standard strengths of the Rapid Jab of building percent, but it's the rare jab that kills. Which, that combination together makes it a very scary thing to see at the high percents. I just have to wonder how much different that set would have gone if Yin had found the confirm into the down B meteor smash. Because that would have been a huge swing in his favor. Going back to Battlefield. Just gets two in that situation. Pretty understandable. It's not the ladder comboing monster that it was in Smash 4 after all. Not able to get a further confirm off of that up there. Ooh, that was just narrowly missing the Mecha Koopa with that down B. Yep, I've got a match to play, so I'll be back later.
Alrighty, hopping in here mid-game, see what's going on here. Gnome, Yin, looks like 1-1. Yin, Gnome, one stock down for Gnome. And Yin is just holding on to this 144%. Pretty much anything from... Okay, well, that will kill, yeah. Okay, yeah, and pretty much even stocks going into this here. Question is, will Yin be able to get around all the Mecha Koopas, aerials, shenanigans, to be able to get some aerials of his own? Probably, I don't know, Flip Kick, that's a ZSS shenanigans there, but who knows. Coming down with the drill and punish with that frame one jab. Absolutely ridiculous move. And yep, that has super armor. Only Grab's going to be able to break through that. Ooh, nice up air, love it. And yep, now hit him with the spike hitbox there. Trying to treat him fair, not getting him there. Once again, going right in with that flip kick, getting right around the Mecha Koopa, not have to worry about it at all. And the armor just going through the entirety of that. Holy cow. Ooh, looks like Yin tried to do some Zer, probably Z-drop shenanigans, but didn't quite work. And yep, grounded up B, that's gonna work. And Yin just waiting out that invincibility from respawn. Now it's back to potentially the last stock of this set here, with no need to take this game. Stock. I'm not here for it. Yeah, and Flip Kick, just a great option for getting around that Mecha Koopa and the Uppy entirely. And once again, that side B armor coming in clutch. Really, really useful move for closing in the gap there. I'm genuinely surprised that didn't hit there, but that jab will, and it'll kill. The strongest kill jabs in the game, I believe. Really, really good move. And yeah, this is possible for anyone here, although, one near flip kick away. As everyone always is, I swear. Ooh, trying to go for the rare raw B there, and fortunately not hitting. Side B up air. Ooh. And percentage is closing in very fast. Coming with the side B, using that armor to get around anything that Yin throws out, and making it back. Things are looking pretty even here. No one really wanted to pull the trigger on approaching in a little bit too greedily. Ooh. No, just Yin's not able to get any real thing into a kill confirm right now. And that's what's going on. Oh, wait, I spoke too soon. That's going to be it.
That one's side B on the offstage.
Alrighty.
Fair enough. Holy shit. I wanted that. I really wanted that.
What makes this so much better is seeing the camera here, and then, like, that camera's fine, but sometimes the camera for this player is just at, like, 5 FPS. So I see, like, Yin popping off, like, eh.
It's crazy that you still have retained so much of the knowledge from the past, to, like, how to utilize the different, like, tracking the angle that I'll get sass, like,
the return missionary power up is real. Temp. Yeah. Temp is still doing it.
Yeah, that's
sick. So, like, a little bit before I got the kill off the left side, that when I had him off the right side and he was going high and I did the like weird side B, I was supposed to be flip kick, I just go to change my angles too early. So I think I would have gotten the kill there, but I still held it out.
It shocks me how much armor that side B has.
Dude, his side B is insane.
I mean, I don't have to worry about it too much as a center because my side B beats his side B.
Yeah.
But your only option there is like grab, right?
So grab, back air beats the armor. Boost kick goes through it.
Really? Yeah. I'm guessing because it hits the Koopaling instead of the cart. Because yeah. The cart is what has the armor.
Yeah, right? So if you hit the Koopaling, you're fine. So, like, if I position fair, so, like, I have to do, like, rising fair. But even then, like, chances, I think the cart still hits me anyways. Like, it's just not worth it. If I position nair right, but that's, like, super difficult to do because, like, he's moving very fast as a small hitbox.
Right.
And like ZSS is like very, very particular with where she wants to move. But yeah, no, that game, all three kills came from a grounded flip pick upbeat.
Really? I missed the first one.
Yeah,
so I didn't get to see
which
it.
The first two was just him not respecting it. Right. And that third one was just the call out on the tongue because he had gotten that. I think that's how he got both stocks that game.
One of those stocks, he tried to do tongue, missed.
Oh, yeah, and then he got the jab.
Which
though.
Is weird. I felt like that tongue should have landed.
Nah, because so, like there's only.
Like two frames.
I just waited. There's a frame in between you getting up and shield. And so I just. Got up a little bit later, which I didn't go for shield, which I should have.
Yeah.
I think I went for jab. I don't know. But
I think you're too far away for that to work, because
maybe. He was like right up next further. To me too, though.
Maybe I can't remember.
But like tongue has some mad hurtbox shifting, so. Right. But yeah, no. That last kill was the only one that I actually like read him for something rather than him just disrespecting flip kick. Which I mean, if you're just disrespecting flip jump, then I'm gonna do it off of ledge.
That's the biggest thing one needs to be aware of in the ZSS matchup is flip kick.
Yeah. It's which. Okay, the one thing he recognized really quickly, which was really good of him, because he had been doing a really good job of mixing up low and high, and then the second stock of game two, the only stock of game two, I caught, he was going side B over to the, like, just the ledge, and I could just drop down up B that, and so I did that and caught him. And so, like, I was trying the whole time to set up for, like, low recoveries. That way I could come up, and that's just a free kill at, like, 80, 70. Right. Because it catches the Koopaling himself, so. But
beyond, like, you know, flip kick, I think the other thing you just need to really be aware of in the versus ZSS matchup is just to respect landing aerials on her, especially now.
Which, a lot of, like, Wits and Bao Zhao's game plan automatically does that, right? Because it's a lot of, like, auto Koopa or Mecha Koopa and then a lot of like cart side B
right.
And so like the whole time like I'm having to be careful of my landing aerials instead
right.
It was fun though.
Yeah,
I love
good
Wit. Man, I am shaky though.
Who's up on stream next?
I don't know. Trey and
oh it's you and me. Oh okay. I mean let me change this. What character are you going so I can change it on here? I'm going Incineroar, so it's... I was trying to help!
battle. Incineroar!
Yeah.
battle. Thank you. Stock Battle, King K. Rool.
Haven't seen this in a while. Ooh, that's no good. This game looks decently even, okay? Though then again, that is the difference with the K. Rool, who's rarely struggling to find a stock, versus Duck Hunt, who notoriously struggles to take stocks before... Okay, there's a good kill, confirm. Smart use of the up tilt, and we're seeing some very interesting projectile interactions right from both of them, because they have a lot of, they both have two really good ones, and then Duck Hunt has another kind of projectile move, the gunman. Seems like Oa's starting to run away with it for the moment. We'll see if that, and that is the, and that is the match.
Dude, your Duck Hunt is so fun to watch.
Not that, against a heavy.
That grabbing to cam is crazy.
Oh, looks like I'll be up against Sunny T myself in that. Then.
It's awesome because that's Cable's best match.
Yeah, that's an interesting one. Wouldn't expect that, but.
Yeah, I was kind of. My inputs weren't that good, but most of the time you can't do anything. If he recovers high, just up air, because he can only narrow it. And if he recovers low, just down air.
It was so cool. He tossed his can off the stage and he grabbed you and threw you into it. It was so sick.
I love Duck Hunt.
I mean, as a Duck Hunt, you really have to become a master of maximizing every confirm. You get one grab, and pretty much every other combo of yours should be ending in a can. Part of the reason is because you can't really afford to miss any of those combos because his KO power is dreadful.
That was a really fun set to watch.
Kind So who do we get on screen next? Did Sunny T... Well, let's... So we've got, for our first top 8 match on stream, Taminus versus KJ. Fortunately, I probably won't get to be commentating this for very long, if at all, because I've got to play my next match against Sunny T.
Well, good luck, have fun.
Where's Sunny T going?
I don't know. I think he's going to play you.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Did I make top 8?
Is there... Was there even any doubt?
I don't know. Maybe I have
one. Well, I've got to go play my match against Sunny T, so... Open mic? Not... Well, nah. But if anybody wants to, they're free. Okay. Well, I guess I'm commentating for the time being. Fox versus Joker. That's not a matchup we see too often. Both are very combo heavy and KO power heavy characters. The one only has that in their super form. Ugh, that was an awkward miss. I wonder if he meant to do the forward smash the other way. Ooh, there's a nice one. Yep, not a lot that KJ can do in that situation. So great edge guarding from Taminus. Very even game here. Well, I guess I've got to go now. Be back.
wins. Mission complete.
We've done it!
Stop battle! Fox! Joker!
Okay. Well, like this game, we've got KJ in a pretty bad spot here. Far behind, and Samnus still has at least one more Arsene in the cards. So it's going to be really rough for KJ to take this game. Going to need to... And that's all it takes. Okay. That puts Taminus on in a match point. And well, one awkward thing for Fox in this matchup is that it pays if you can find those early edge guards against Joker, because that can stuff out an Arsene before he really has a chance to utilize it. But Fox's edge guarding game is not very good. He can occasionally go for like the shine spike cheese, but that's generally about the extent of his edge guarding. It's just not. He just does not have great capabilities in that regard. It's too risky. But that was a nice start. KJ finding the stock early, denying Taminus much chance to utilize that first Arsene. And on the plus side for Fox in this matchup is that since he's rarely a character that struggles to find the stock, that is a huge bonus to him in this matchup, because it means that you're pretty much never going to be seeing Arsene more than once in a stock.
I think we're going to find out who it is. Is it? Yeah, that's
the only way that can really happen is if the Joker gets a good read with the...
No,
really good read with the Rebels guard. And
he looks
guard.
Cute.
Ooh, there's an up smash. Not quite enough to close out the stocks. Probably if he finds another one. There's the classic Joker combo. Drag down into grab.
Use a starfish.
This is where it could be scary, Kate. Fox has a very exploitable recovery. Did manage to get back to stage in neutral. That's a good trade for KJ, though. He needs to end this stock soon, because if he doesn't, it won't be long before second Arsene comes out to play. As I made clear, you never want to see a second Arsene on any stock. Ooh, there's a... That is a big forward smash attempt, and he's going to eat the back air punish for it.
I really just think it looks really good.
Janice is like, heavily fishing for the back air to start an edge guard.
Like,
AJ just
so
not giving it to him.
Like, this one has so much more personality.
Ooh, so close. That was a great attempt, but just didn't quite outspace it. Yeah, there's the Arsene. Okay, he got the stock, and now he has a chance to utilize it on the last stock. This could be a big momentum swing. If Taminus, that's going to put KJ off stage.
She is a seahorse.
But it's rapidly running out. Can he close it out before it's gone? No. Then, no.
We're getting the war.
Automatically makes this game significant. That was a huge Rebels guard. It's giving him a second Arsene, and that's really scary against Fox, because he is a lightweight. But KJ finding the up air read to close out the game. Very, very fortunate, because with that second Arsene, that... It would have been very easy for that game to become a steamroll by Taminus.
That was looking dangerous.
But with that, we are on to game 5.
Daphne! No, it's not Daphne. It's, don't you remember the literally random...
Scooby-Doo? What? Daphne?
No.
Daphne the flower.
It's don't you remember the random flower nip that, like, someone was trying to put Katie's out with? It was like, marry this girl.
Oh, yeah.
That's her.
Yeah.
Now on to game five. Two players playing their hearts out, giving it their all to. This will determine who gets to go to grand finals and is guaranteed a payout tonight.
Oh, this is game five. Dallin, this is game five.
Indeed. Okay, overextends and it puts him in a bad position where he's forced off stage. Fortunately, as I said, what was that? That, I just, misinputs? Trying to psych him out. Ooh, and Taminus gets caught by the, missing the tech and loses the stock. But gets the back air edgeguard to take the first one. Keeping it close here.
She's me for real.
Oh, this is tense. Both really respecting each other's space, just trying to stay just out of range. Taminus really respecting the up tilts there, not trying to punish him, just getting out to safety. Now has the Arsene, which it all, if he can put it to good use, that'll be a, could be a big swing here. Right now, it's KJ is getting all the right reads, which is rapidly gonna grind it down to non-existence. And there it goes. Didn't really get much out of that one. So still, but yeah, this is where it could get. Going for the just simple Rebel's Guard instead of the Edge Guard. This after the last time he tried to Edge Guard it and it failed, I can respect that. Still, that is the. It's dangerous to fish for the a second Arsene against Fox, because it's very rare he's going to let you live long enough to do that. Ooh, that was a good attempt, just timing was a bit off. Probably should have gone for the counter. There's another dash attack. Good patience from KJ, not giving him the easy stock, and might not even tip. And with that, that's probably going to be it for this Arsene. And went high. Tough. Unfortunate. KJ taking the set. Taminus going to loser's bracket. Next up, we'll most likely be having Oa and Greed on stream. But it's possible we might start throwing some.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I think that's the only match to throw on stream right now. Yes, it is. Okay, I've got to go play my match, so I'll set this up for these two, and then be on my way. Yep, we're good.
Battle. Let's battle. Ridley in a roll.
Two, one, go!
Thank you.
Yep, so that was indeed game three. Oh, taking it in a 3-0. That's just Oa for you. So Oa is going to be sitting pretty. And seems like.
Like, I remember
everything.
Just
Huh? Oh, giving KJ some useful advice. So, respect. Well, for now, Oa will be sitting pretty in grand finals, awaiting his final challenger. We've got quite the lineup for who could be challenging him, so most likely we'll be... There aren't any matches to throw on stream right now because we need to wait for Meeks and Ant to finish their set. Whoever wins that will be going up against Reed. So, enjoy the frog! And we are back. Whoops, do not need to be running that app right now. Oh, it's... Looks like we've got Meeks... So not Ant, my bat, my B. Are we really about to see randoms? I somehow doubt this. And of course, Greed out here showing that he's a big deal. I am very funny. Let's get it on the let's get it going. So, interesting that he chose to close it out with Meeks coming out swinging, just starting very explosively, completely snuffing out what could have otherwise been a big revenge. But Greed striking back. Gonna put Meeks back off stage. Good fair. Not gonna get. Ooh, this. Just not. Neither player able to find the finishing blow. But it's back to even percents here. Stock. Okay, just the charge shot punish on the up B. Definitely could have gotten a bigger punish out of that. They just keep sending each other flying, neither taking a stock. That's going to change eventually. That is not going to be do it. Meeks has... Okay, there we go. Even with the sour spot, that is a very easy punish for the stock. Yes?
We're just talking about people that I actually know that are here.
Okay.
Oh, is that Bradley?
Oof. Very close game. Missed the chance to capitalize on that charge shot. Eats the lariat.
Yeah, I said mold.
Two back-to-back missed grabs. Awkward for Meeks. That's also what's going to happen. Oh, yikes! That was a devastating punish from Greed with that forward smash taking it at 80%. That gives Greed a big lead here. Will he be able to keep it though? It's very, it won't be very hard for Meeks to find Edgeguard.
You don't have to walk in. They're driving maybe there.
Did it high. Unfortunate. That could have been the punish. Meeks is doing a really good job of avoiding the Alolan whips. I don't think a single one of those has landed this game, which is a big deal against Incineroar. Yeah, Greed is just keeps throwing them out and just cannot find them. Up throw does the trick. Finally. Oof, that was a devastating revenge. Another that Alolan whip was dangerously close. Finally finds its mark. Gonna put Meeks in an awkward spot, but it's not over yet. He can play the. And there's the hard read from Greed with the F tilt, taking game one. Can only avoid the Alolan whip for so long, it would seem.
Yeah,
Meeks thinking hard about that suit counterpick, pulling out the dark suit, right from Prime Echoes, I guess, because this is a dark character? Wait, actually, he is a dark Pokemon. Okay, that actually kind of makes sense.
But you can't be inside here, just so you don't get fired. They don't. They were either thinking it or you're missing.
Ooh, that was a such a good weave. That's
right outside the door.
That's gonna hurt.
Yeah, that's
not gonna take the stock from across stage. We're definitely gonna be a big momentum swing. Landed on the platform and had a lot of end lag, but Meeks didn't go for it. A bit understandable. It probably wasn't prepared for that much end lag on the move. Oof, and that's what can happen if he tries to challenge it. If it doesn't land, it recovers pretty quickly, and you can get punishes like that. Just going for the charge shot punish on the up B, that is a big wasted opportunity, but finds a stock with the Nair at least. So not making too much of a difference in the end. There's a good punish. Get it? Already expending the revenge on that Sour Spot fair. Neutral beam. Oof! That was a big down air for some big damage. Interesting. The grabs canceled each other out. Only gets the Sour Spot, but still, respectable choice. Oh, just barely missing, and that might... No, not quite, but dangerously close. Just barely avoiding the edge guard, but falls to the F-tilt read. Reed taking the second stock. There's a revenge. Yeah, that's a particularly scary one just because of the revenge, so does that much more shield damage, right? That might do it.
That's it.
Ouch! That was a devastating game two. It would seem that the dark suit was not able to handle the dark type Pokemon. That does not seem to. I guess it was because the fire did it. It had to be the fire.
Oh, of course. Well, it had to be the fighting because that's what darks move to. Alolan Whip. It's a wrestling move, so fighting type.
I don't know.
You don't know the type matchups.
Does the fighting be dark?
It does.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am not a wizard in Pokemon. I fully admit.
I don't like Pokemon anymore, but I used to be a huge fan as a kid. And this is not what I would put my money into.
Yeah. So. Nothing against the franchise. I watched Detective Pikachu. That movie's pretty nice. I just never really got into the games. I'm like the Harry Potter fan who only watches the movies and not the books. And I will not mention Harry Potter again for the rest of the stream for reasons that should be obvious.
Well, I think as long as you say you don't love the author, you should be fine.
Yeah.
Because everyone still loves Harry Potter.
Yep, that is a franchise that isn't going anywhere anytime, probably ever.
Yeah, that's quite true. Or at least for a long time.
Indeed. This game's looking pretty good for Meeks, though. There's always the risk that they're of a big swing with the revenge. That was a big chunk of damage.
44%.
And that is the... That's the danger of letting the Incineroar live. You can get those big swings with just one Alolan Whip. Down tilt, of all things, closing out the stock.
Samus down tilt is still going so hard. It's like frame 4 or something. This is like, might be hyperbole. I don't know the facts, but it's really, really fast. And it kills at like 120. It's like her, it's better than her upbeat and like just killing you, you know? Mm-hmm. So if someone's just ahead in front of you and you think they're getting like spotlights or something, you're just down to what you're doing.
Want to get closer to the mic?
Yeah, sure. I'll join you. I haven't commentated in a while, but.
Yeah, it's fun. It can be fun, and that. Well, it's interesting is that if you have full shield, you can shield the first three hits of the lariat, and it's the fourth one that will break your shield. But if you can practice parrying that can be a big opportunity for punishing. Though for Samus, maybe not as much because her forward smash is generally going to be out of the sweet spot range.
Well, like. It depends. Depending on how you're shield DI'ing and how the Incineroar is moving on you, you can break out of it with like nairs and stuff. And that's probably what Samus is going to be looking for there. A nair or a back air, because that's what's going to be killing the Dual Mountain. Or the grab, depending on the percent, right? Yep. Sometimes you just want more of it.
That's
jumped into it.
Yep, with the power of revenge, there was no question. Still, this is Meeks' game to lose.
Definitely going to have to ask Green how he feels about Sky J, because it looks like he's taken a lot of inspiration from his play, especially with the short hop side Bs, which are notorious. It's notoriously used by Sky J to put a lot of pressure in the corner.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, I'd be surprised. You'd be foolish not to, because like before Sky J, maybe not everybody, but a good portion of the player base thought Incineroar was bottom three.
Like, whoa, that's cap. That's good. But, no, I get what you're saying. He slept on a lot. A lot of people think he's, like, mid-tier even though he is.
And there's still a case to be made, because...
It's still the same character, right? It's just that Sky J exists.
Yeah, Sky J's... Well, every once in a while, you get a player who's so good that they single-handedly push their character several spots up to the tier list. And in Ultimate... Sky J is one of those players.
Yeah, and I want to point out that I've been on the train that he's high tier since day one. I've seen the light for this guy. Even Sky J doesn't think he's high tier, but like, first of all, Incineroar but Fast is the best character in the game. Just get that out of the way.
Yeah.
Right? He has some of the best aerials in the game, some of the best normals in the game, some of the best specials. It's just like everything about him is so good. His only weakness, literally only, is his sometimes meteoric recovery, but even then it can kill you at zero and there's true combos into it and it has super armor. And then he's slow, right?
Yep.
And sometimes bad range. But like everything else is so amazing about this character.
Yeah, and one big thing that he has that no other slow characters do is the revenge. Because that forces you to play so much differently than most characters. Because
good job.
It just builds the fear factor. Because once you get, they have a fully loaded revenge, you can die at like 50.
Oh, I think someone's in chat. But no, 100%. And that's... I can see this, Koru. Hello. It's nice to see you. Anyway, but that's exactly what's so scary about Incineroar, right? Is he has the normals to beat you out in the scraps, which is where he places you just by existing because of side view. And then once he gets you into the corner, he probably has slight revenge. And if you do the wrong option, you're dying at 55.
And just to randomly put it out there, Koru's the... an Ogden player who's probably a better... Okay, let's be real. A better Ness than me. He's the new Fleepy, I guess.
Koru is the GOAT. Koru... I love Koru. They almost beat me at Coliseum this week. Which is fair. That matchup's terrible. Koru's good. Especially against me.
Nice to see you in the chat too, Abe. Oh!
Yeah.
You're... Okay. You just come up for the Coliseum. Respect!
Yeah. Hammy, Koru, and Gerudo are all probably. They're all my goats, too. I love all of them.
As for this match, well, looks like another. Meeks is starting out strong. He's already taken the stock, and we'll see if it can stay that way, because Incineroar is a very swingy character.
Oh, 100%. And what I'm seeing right now is Meeks doing kind of. a Zelda. Sorry, I couldn't think of the character. You know, kind of using his projectiles to just control Smashville and make it so this entire stage is his range. Normally, this is an amazing stage for Incineroar, but I think Meeks is doing a great job of controlling the space of the map to make sure that he's winning all these interactions and controlling the way that Greed can get in.
That was a very greedy attempt at the forward smash, but just was too far in for it to find its mark.
That F smash is enigma to me. I literally don't know where the sweet spot is. It just sometimes does, sometimes doesn't. Aw, yeah. Thank you, Koru. I'm a big Koru fan.
Yep, that was a big back air. Okay, that's generally the proper use of the Samus jab.
That was such good tracing.
You just use it, go for the hit, and then run back and try and trap the opponent, because the second hit is not true at all, and if it gets shielded, you're often in for a pretty big punish.
Oh yeah, 100%. People like Siski, and I don't know Yara, but I guarantee Yara does the exact same thing. They don't even go for the second hit. It's always a run back something, always a mix-up of some kind. Because like you're saying, there's almost no point in even going for it, because it almost never connects, and you could get a bigger punish by not connecting it. So why even go for it, you know?
Yeah, it's such a bizarre designly designed jab, because why give it a second hit if it can't be connected into?
Ooh, 100%. And the bombs are going to be taking it. Good play.
Greed SDing with his own revenge. Such is the nature of having a counter on a character with a bad recovery. You do it at the wrong time, and it's just over.
Mm-hmm. It was a buffer.
Yep, buffers. Gotta love the buffer system. Thank you, Sakurai.
Well, now we're on game 5. Definitely going to be looking really, really rough here. And yeah, the buffer's going to be rough. Probably was trying to downbeat one of the bombs. And then, you know, just it got buffered after he got hit by one of the grab ledge. Boom, bang, pow. Happens. Definitely tough, especially for a character like Incineroar. But here we are, game 5. Looking at Meeks has snowballed right now. Let's see if he can keep the momentum.
And let's quickly check on who won the... Oh, they haven't reported.
It was King Hector.
Oh, okay.
Michael told me. Michael is the name of King Hector. His actual name. Not Michael Gaming.
So he is... So that will be the next opponent. The next player we see. Whoever wins here will be facing off against King Hector, which I don't know why he changed it from KH Gaming, because I kind of liked him owning being the Sora player.
I don't remember why. I think he just wanted a new tag. Just wanted something new, you know. Yes. Maybe thought it was a little too silly, and he wanted to get a more serious persona, you know.
Or maybe it was too on the nose for his liking. It's to each their own. But
wait, yeah, Michael, why did you change your tag? Yeah, it's because I remember you told me at one point, obviously, but I forgot. The DDR was one dude.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So it's King Hector because Eli came up with it. He was asking what KH stood for.
Yeah,
and then I got a lot of people actually wondering what KH stood for, so I was like, you know what? We're going to turn it into King Hector, and that's going to be the title.
Yeah,
and King Hector's a lot more based than KH Gaming.
That's a lot of mix-ups right there.
Yeah. Well, there you have it, folks. But
also, I didn't change my tag till after I won my first tournament to symbolize that I was entering the...
Okay. That's kind of what I said. I said you thought it was like a little too silly for you. Which is kind of the gist.
It's literally my PSN tag for the longest time. That's all it was.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I remember the origin. It was
I've had my tag since I had a DS. So
trust me, I'm very happy with my tag. It's very based. And people like it a lot more.
Well, KH did stand for Kingdom Hearts, but that's the joke. Everyone didn't know Abe, and then Elay just put King Hector into it.
Well, that's the thing. So, like, King Hector, you can still call me KH, because I'm still KH. So people still use that nickname for me pretty much as the regular. They don't even use King Hector.
Oh, my God. Ooh, that's a big one.
That might be dead.
Nope.
Barely.
Since fat.
Got the roll read. Still not enough.
That was a toe. It, like, tickled the pixel.
Barely.
Yeah, that was a stock only because of how obscenely high the percent was by Ungreed at that point. But it's good that Meeks took the stock there, because they could have got that with that much rage. you'd never want to face Incineroar with that much rage.
Samus seems to have such good tools for him.
Yeah. Well, yeah, of course. It's like the best ledge trapper in the game versus the slowest character. What do you get, right?
Dude, that's going to put Meeks off stage. Oh, trying to go for the edge guard. Respect the attempt because there's... Green needs something big to get back in this game.
Yeah. It's the food outside.
So at the same time, when you go for those risks, you put yourself at a greater risk of getting punished. Not able to find the F tilt that.
One more game into this, right?
No.
Forward air, still not enough.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yeah, I winner side was winning.
There we go. The roll F tilt read. Ooh, that might be it. I'm not sure if he can get back. Nope.
Yep, okay.
That's the... Such is the nature of Incineroar's recovery. Once you've lost your jump, it's a lot harder to recover, and he just got caught in the air, sent off stage, and that is all there is to it. And with that, our next matchup will be Meeks versus King Hector.
Also, the roll of the R at the end is just awesome.
You're welcome.
Splitter for me? How awesome.
It was your splitter.
Oh, that's right. I donated it to the cash stream.
I went to a card shop before I got 3 marketing machine packs. Got absolute dog shit. It was lit. I bought 2 singles. And the singles aren't there. I don't think anything I got for.
Yep. Well, might be a bit of a wait, so this stream's about to get frogged. Will Meeks accept the gentleman?
I just had it for a
waiting for this to for your next match?
Yeah.
Well, we've got KJ in the audience to see who comes up, who is will be his next opponent. Something tells me that he's hoping for Meeks. Samus Fox is a notoriously very bad matchup for Samus, while against Sora, that's probably more even.
I think so.
That's where I'm at. That's where my career is. I don't like the rest of those things. Gorge.
Indeed. We're going to Battlefield. I figured that if he was going to agree to the Gentlemen's, it was going to be Battlefield, because that's also a pretty good stage for Samus. Because she actually does have her own ladder combos, which can occasionally, if she gets one started really high up, it can take you all the way to the blast zone with someone like any really, really good ladder combo.
Come on, sir. It's been a long time. It's a pleasure to see you again.
Yeah, I'm wondering how much experience does KH Gamer have with this against Samus? Maybe he's played Evasion a bunch since the last time he's been here, so that might keep his Samus knowledge fresh. But otherwise. Well, it will be interesting to see. There we go. Meek's coming out swinging, getting all the right reads here. There we go. Another ledge trap in the bucket. Yep, there's the reliable Fire Aga into dash attack. Confirm every time you get hit by that first one, it's guaranteed. Also, Sora's dash attack is pretty great. Fast, low profiles, and in many ways comparable to Snake. Snake just not quite, just without the fast acceleration. Still, Meeks currently has the lead, but gets. King Hector gets the back air edge guard, bringing it back to even. And there we go. That's the weird interaction that got players killed in Smash 4 with its wacky rage. Fortunately, they've toned that down a lot for this game because, losing your stock to at 0% to those kinds of to select moves. Is just not okay. Right. KH is coming out with the lead for the moment. Going for the grab off of Fire Aga that time. Interesting. Meek's really not doing a good job respecting KH's projectiles. Just keeps getting hit by them. And gets trapped by the Thundaga and the dash attack takes it. Okay, did not land on the platform there. That was kind of weird. Not sure why, but that... Okay, I guess he deliberately fell through and was hoping that Cage wouldn't notice. That Thundaga keeps calling. Yep, Meek's not able to recover from that. The Thundaga is just... Well, it covers a lot of things. It's a great passive edgeguarding tool.
middle dark.
On to game two with Town and City. This one's a bit of an interesting one. It is a stage that lends itself to ladders, and if the, he can get, Meeks can get one started particularly high up, we could see a like practical zero to death out of nowhere. Ooh, gets it, and just, he's finding the charge shot, and not getting the reset to neutral with that side B. Oh, wow, that was a good call out. Ew, and Meeks gets hit right out of the ice, which is exactly what you never want to allow the Sora to do, because that is what one of the KO traps you can find yourself in against him. Going for the edge guarding, respectable, though Samus is not the easiest character to edge guard. Has a lot of ways to mix it up with those bombs. That was so many back-to-back missed KO opportunities, which is awkward for Meeks. But charge shot, fully charged at that percent on the side of the stage. Doesn't need him to be much more than that. Okay, good patience from KH there to wait for the air dodge and punish it. Going for the jump. Oh no, he gets the up air punish on the up B. Speaking of ladder combos, that could have been the stock, but Meeks just did not go in that direction. Meeks staying out of range and now has KH off stage. Ooh, misjudged the missile and ran right into the Thundaga for the second stock. As I said, it's a really good edge guarding tool. Not much more needs to be said about it. But Meeks with the big confirmed charge shot into the sweet spot forward smash, taking an early stock and bringing the game back to even. It's either player's game, though it's definitely looking like Hector is running away with it. Just getting simple. Was hoping that Meeks would be caught off guard, but went off stage instead. Gets the Nair loop into up smash, just not able to take the stock quite yet. And that is just barely surviving with some good directional influence. That's still not enough. Meeks running out of room for error. At this point, it's... Okay, F-tilt is not quite enough. But that up-tilt, still not enough. Not often you see Samus living to these percents. But I think at this point, you could sneeze at Meeks and it would be over. So, never mind. Dash attack, not going to do it. Not known for its KO power, which is probably a good thing because that move would be straight up broken if it could actually kill reliably. Okay, this is a pretty scary, and that is finally going to do it. KH almost losing grip of that game, but closing it out by the skin of his teeth. King Hector on game, on match point. But it is not over yet, folks. That game came down to the wire. All it really took at that percent was for Meeks to get one really good read and to close it out, which is very doable with Samus because her ledge trapping game is such a nightmare. There's a good punish on the up B. Not something you see too often. Oh, not again. Got Meeks on in a bad spot. This is Meeks' chance to turn it around. Good charge shot into dash attack. Gets the grab to keep KH off stage. Falls off the stage, giving Meeks a path to safety. Ooh, but finds the air dodge read on the platform for the first stock. But Meeks answering back, not quite able to take it with that confirm, but we're close. It's so awkward playing around the Thundaga because it has three hits, and so you have to respect them or else it can be your demise. Finally gets a nair trade to close out the stock. 68% it's a deficit, but not one that is impossible to overcome. Ooh, and there's a very good call out by King Hector with the forward smash, taking the second stock. Meeks is in a very bad spot here. Gonna need something big to get back in this game. Last game it was the charge shot into forward smash, but he already used that trick once this game. I'll be surprised if he can find it again. Did live to like 200% in the last game, so that could happen again. It probably doesn't want to, but I'd be surprised if KH allows that to happen again. Went for a read with that jab and did not find it. Oh no. Ooh, catches him with that up B, and that is the match. KH taking it 3-0. Sorry, KJ. You're... Why do you think I
assume KJ's going to be in the
sentence. So you're like the Radiohead song, but not a creep.
Yes. You ready? Yeah. Have fun.
What? Yeah. What was that?
Still jealous of your son, to this day. But you know, honestly, it's
so now that I think about it, KJ is probably the most improved. In the last quarter, KJ is easily the most improved player we've seen. He went from being about my level, and now he's. And we've seen him, like, back to back for grands, right? Or. Well, you've seen him in grands several times this season, so. Or have we? Well, it's not grands yet. It's losers finals, and it's to be determined if he can get to grands against KH King Hector. Going to Battlefield for the starter. Because, yeah, it makes sense. Fox is a ladder heavy character, so there's definitely a lot of benefits to going to this stage for Fox. Look for the up smash to try and maximize the damage. Okay, it's wisely going for some edgeguard. Just did not quite find it. Yeah, it's a good F tilt. Gonna put KH, and yeah, nothing he can do about that. In fact, now that I think about it, okay, never mind. Going for the back air punish on the down smash. That's an odd choice. I feel like an up smash would have been the stock. And we're okay this time, going for a slightly different angle to avoid the counter, which there's gonna put him in a bad spot. Not sure what KH was looking for. Probably an up smash and just got shield poked. Now to 2-stock deficit. Okay, needs getting a lot of damage out of the classic up tilt spam at low percent. Ooh, good air dodge to avoid the up smash. KH doesn't really have an easy way back into this game. He's gonna have to play it really well and to take it. And once again, the Thundaga finding its mark. It just goes so low. Interesting. Forward smash canceling out the Fire Aga. Going high this time. Odd that he went for the jab. It's possible that was a misinput for an up smash. That seems like the most likely reason. Still looking for that second stock. That probably could have... That F-tilt on shield probably could have been an up smash punish, but it's understandable that he was being conservative about it. Not wanting to just throw away a stock willy-nilly.
Yeah.
Cage starting out this game better. Going to small battlefield, which is probably better. Interesting choice, Cage. Trying to fish for a two frame with the down smash. Really wants the down smash. Oh, there. A respectable attempt. Just swinging out a lot of up smash attacks, none of them landing. Side. That'd be good. Ooh, and there we go.
Yeah, block pass. Just
the sudden up smash to close out the stock.
Your seat got stolen.
Wait, I can move. I can change.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm sure you're going to
Yes.
Interesting. Sorry. Cage going for the down smash instead of the.
Well, I'm just taking the bad
counter. I guess that's because Cage still had time to redirect the direction to avoid that.
I have a feedback too.
I want
a
yoga.
Quite nice.
You do?
I wish I got a bigger one though. I got one for my. I wanted one for like.
There we go. Gets the opening with the jab. Missing the opportunity to punish the.
Feedback chair for my birthday.
And I got second, but I guess it is kind of hard to be ready for that. For there's always the threat of the third one.
Yeah, and I was gonna get like a 5-footer.
And there's the second first stock off KJ.
Uh-huh. I was gonna get like a 5-footer, and but my mom and my brother talked me out of it. And so I never
so much stalling from KH, not wanting to give KJ an easy
and it's
easy way,
like it's
way to call
to
out
like,
him
it's more
on
than
the ledge.
To, like, sit in and
back
like,
air,
a giant pillow. I have
puts
a giant
KJ off stage, another F tilt.
Well, like,
quickly
have, like, laid down, it's
take
like,
finding his
like
way back into this game.
I mean, you could, but like your
okay,
body
just going for the down smash. It just was facing the wrong direction for
still
smash. Really, the shine.
Slanted over.
Well, that sounds like a tall person problem.
My grandparents have two like 6-foot by 6-foot beanbags, and they're huge, and they're so.
And
cool.
Went for
they're
the up smash read. Fortunately, KH not ready to go for a harder punish. And there's another up smash for the stop.
Like the house that we were at earlier?
Yeah. There and there. I'll have to
we
show
break
you.
In.
I could if you want.
No, let's not actually. I'd rather.
And there's a well-timed nair to reset to neutral.
They'll be back by.
Very good patience from KJ,
oh, no,
not allowing
which is like
H to take the stock with it, any of those. That uppy will finally take it. KJ still has a solid lead here. If he doesn't get too greedy or allow. Well, game still hit. He still is favored to win this game. He just needs to not let.
Let
KH get any big combos or cheese.
We dare you.
Except
the fact you're going to be
and there we go. The classic nair into up smash for the game.
Okay.
DDR. Was that game two?
That was game two. We got Ella in the audience to get some pre-match knowledge on what to expect from his opponent. On to game three, both. It's an even match.
It's not even that bad, it's just stupid. Why would you like that?
I mean, I know that KH likes this stage
no,
along
say,
with
yeah,
FD.
Like, it was a joke, but obviously.
Ooh, and that was a big two frame.
Do I need more napkins?
Oh, okay.
Catches him rolling and keeps him. Trying to go for it again. KJ finally getting back to neutral. Just Yeah, this is an interesting stage to take.
The legs are tucked underneath
KJ
the basket.
Too,
could I?
Yeah.
On the one hand, I know that King Hector likes it, stage, but it's also one where that is also playing to Fox's strengths. You always have to be playing with the. When you're landing, you're always at threat of getting caught by the. Vortex. Fox Vortex? Yeah.
It's not my fault. I'm only one of
the. Ooh, that's a baby. Ouch. That's. An awkward SD from King Hector. Likely going to cost him the game, but it's to be determined.
My stomach hurts so like Greens ball.
We can't talk about the Greens anymore. You'll never get it off your mind. Pretty soon, you're going to be like on your
feet. Ooh! A stall forward smash, finding its mark.
Can we try that out?
Yep, going for the Thundaga, and that is going to give him an easy up smash punish. KJ on match point.
Grease.
Grease.
That's your future.
That's our future tag.
Grease?
No.
You'll be like
going a different direction with that one.
You know why Dylan's tag is Sharpie? Well, it's Baja Blue, but you know why it was Sharpie?
I feel like you told me about it.
It's because it's like. Sniff Sharpie.
Yeah, he sniffed Sharpie. Like in sixth grade. And he thought it was like the sickest thing ever. Like it's like.
Here we go again. That last game was mainly KJ's because of that
like
unfortunate SD. So
KJ
can just avoid that mistake, making that mistake again. They should still be in the running to take this match. Did a good job keeping him in disadvantage, though. Oh, missing the up smash this time. A bit unfortunate for KJ. Might have been a bit stock. Not ready for that landing there to hit, and as a result misses the hit. Great punish on the Lizaga, taking the first stock of this game.
That I think that's there's some like misogyny or like what's the opposite of that?
Misandry.
Misandry. I don't think that's okay.
I got a bit distracted with Oa's discussion. Don't ask me why that term came up. Game to Cage finding the first stop of it off of KJ.
Oh, yes, he would.
Great read on the neutral getup from KJ, building up his lead further. There's the jab, that Nair is so safe.
Even you.
Interesting, just going for the Nair to put him in disadvantage. Guess probably the right move. I don't think it would quite take the stock to go for this up smash at that percent.
I tried to conjure my most hate.
Interesting. Went for the ledge trump there, but KH using the eye to get out of there in time.
I told you that I watched like half of it just to see the Ganon, and Ganon looks so cool. I might get it, and he sounds so cool. I just want the next Smash game to get out so I can see what that game is gonna look like. And he had like this glowing, like, I don't even know how to describe it. Just like this really big man bun, it would be like glowing down.
H not bringing it back. But gets back air punished for the Thundaga for the second stock.
That's fair enough. Like, don't you feel pressured because even if like the rest of us don't want it, it's fine.
Oof.
It's not
a KH finding a up the punish and bringing it back to even it's so either player's game. But KH cannot afford to lose this one if he wants to continue on in the bracket.
I don't know. It's just something you can check. Or I could
There's
check,
a
right?
nice confirm off of the the down air.
Have you been to Coldstone?
It's open till 11.
Oh my gosh, I need to
take nice counter. KJ ready to going for the damage up smash punish on the Lizaga.
But before we go next week, we'll go get closer.
Nice forward smash. Not going to be taking the stock at that percent from the mid stage. It's a tense game. Here, it could end at any second.
It's good lower back support.
I just need one good read.
It really does.
Okay, it probably needs at least a few more good reads than that. That almost did it.
It's impossible. You get a beanbag.
It just falls off.
Yeah, and it's so easy.
Is that gonna do it? No, not even close.
That's bad. Don't do that.
No,
misses the grab. That is going to be the game. We're on to game 5.
Big Joe.
The Big Joe?
I think it's called
Big
Joe.
I love
Big
Joe.
What's Big Joe?
It's like the best beanbag chair brand.
You guys
That's not super expensive. I think they're the best. They're the best for the money.
I need to have you
both over to my My 3.5 footer was. I mean, they have different. They have different.
$40.
They have different.
Yeah.
The Moana.
Match. It all comes down to this.
No.
One will be walking away at third. The other will be getting a shot at taking down Oa. Which, granted, is like getting thrown into the cage against the gorilla, but. Or I guess crocodile, because the gorilla is a different character, okay?
Yeah, I hate that guy. I don't rep him, totally.
I really like
this is efficient. Your tails looks okay.
Interesting. Good capitalization and this side B getting a bit more damage.
Yes.
That was a respectable attempt, missing the punish window on the down air. Well, that's also a tricky move to punish.
We can even go to Dollar Tree and...
it's gotta be one solid color.
Oof. So yeah, that's the scary thing about the Thanaga. It's so hard to evade.
I can do this, though.
Well, you're my favorite nail painter. Even if you're not good at it, so.
My favorite nail artist is.
Doesn't get the finishing blow. Interesting that KH didn't even attempt to go for the counter there. That probably would have been a really free counter. I don't think there's anything KJ could do there except go straight up.
I can't find it.
So it also would have been a risk of that he could get out there, down there in time.
It's slightly, I think I got my
KJ taking the first stock. We'll see if how long it takes for KH to answer back.
And that one's too expensive, but it looks very similar in the same range. Also, they have multiple,
Yeah, that's probably going to be the what decides the match.
I want to get that one. Well, that back support is quite nice. I like the sacks and just getting.
I just don't know what to say. That is such a sad and unfortunate end that it likely is going to cost KH the match. he's definitely playing like it. Fall into back-to-back nairs. If he takes this match, it's going to be a miracle.
And I was like, randomly, and I was like, oh, the third from Gregory Hamilton Douglas III. It's
tribute to Gregory.
Yeah, that's literally how we got the name. It just naturally happened.
If I buy another dragon plushie, I'm going to buy
okay. Has KJ down to his last stock, so this it could happen. But KH does not have any room for error. Because if KJ if he gives him KJ one chance to up smash, it's over.
Does Naruto want to become the seventh Hokage?
Mild spoilers. He wants to become the next Hokage.
Yeah,
but the next Hokage. Well,
that is going to be the match. Admirable effort. Yeah,
and then
I don't blame.
So there's two.
Nothing against. Nothing to say about it.
Yeah,
King Hector just SD'd
in
two crucial moments
got,
in that.
Used, like, 12-year-old little
SD'd twice capable, in that match, and that second
one
was he could not afford an SD in that. In a match this intense.
They had him go for like training and crap. Basically, he was like only 16, and so like I don't know. They're like, oh, he's too young and inexperienced, so they got a different guy, which would be at the very beginning. That's also mild spoil. Probably shouldn't say that.
I didn't hear it. That's good. But I'm not gonna watch it.
Oh, okay. That's weird. Naruto is very good.
Like Minato, but my time's up.
Minato is literally my favorite character, or one of mine.
Minato? That's the girl, right?
Naruto's dead.
What?
Naruto's dead.
Oh,
looks like. Okay, KJ is going to report it.
Okay.
Bad luck!
Whoa.
Just kidding!
We've got the run back on deck as KJ just gets his second chance to take down the Crocs. So let's be real, folks. If there is a food chain between foxes and crocodiles probably would be higher on that food chain. But I'm pretty sure these animals exist in very different parts of the country. So, has there ever been a meeting in the wild between a fox and a crocodile outside of maybe a zoo? Probably not.
But I was like, man, I'm feeling the salsa.
It's not even spicy.
No, I'm feeling it's good.
Don't tell me that was good.
No. I just told you it was good. You're not
listening. I think they're
all there. No!
I don't
pay attention.
Wait a second. What? Who did that?
I don't think you could label that.
Did you break stream, Taylor?
Sorry for that you have been missing in the game audio. Yeah, folks, never, ever plug the anything into the Switch headphone plug for the stream. That interferes with the audio output to the stream, which, so for the entire duration of that it was plugged in, we cannot get that sound to you guys, to the stream. So yeah, bad. Whoever did that is probably not going to be in a ton of trouble, but if it happens again, I will find you. Okay, that rant over. Let's back to the match.
Mm.
Ooh, there's a nice jab lock. Also, why is Oa pulling out the Ridley? Guess he just wants to grind him to ensure that he's a serious character he can rely on. Still, kind of weird.
A whole text out to my mom got distracted and then left. And I just looked right back. It was only like 5 minutes ago, so.
Him and he'll see that I'm typing for an hour. He's like, are
very
you
close
okay?
game at the moment.
Yeah. I do that so often.
AJ definitely has the lead, but it could evaporate if Oa finds a good side B. Okay, not able to recover. Which. Yeah, that checks out. I think side B would have set him too low to be able to up B back to stage. So he had to up B to get back, and he just could not. Speaking of not being able to get back to stage with up B. That's one of the biggest pitfalls you run into when you pick up a new character. You're gonna mess up their recovery a lot more than you would your main. I'd be not enough.
I mean, it was the reading set. But anyways, you got this whole passage here, and also there's a break. And there's a whole paragraph in this one sentence, and it's just, did I mention that it comes so hard? Like, that was the whole thing. That was the one. Did I mention it? So, Clubcraft is passive, right?
That was,
yeah. Got, like, all of those paragraphs that are mostly connected. But then all of a sudden, there's, like, a total break.
Starting out with this next game pretty strong too.
Someone's just trying to make it work so hard for like 20 years.
I have a lot of attempts and none of them worked. They had to keep in the stock. Oh, this time going high to catch the side B and takes the first stock with barely 11% to his name. Very strong start.
No, whatever.
Kind of this way, but it's very different.
Everyone was laughing. Well, no, he was telling us a story about how he used to try to make it work. Where he's like, no one ever.
Oh, was just finding every right read. That could have been an up smash. Otherwise, oh! Speaking of right reads, getting the back air on the side B.
See if he actually realizes.
KJ should probably be able to take this stock, though I would be surprised if he didn't manage much more than that. Interesting. Oh, not going for the full wall of pain, just ending it off. Gets up smash punished for that down air, and goes for the Ridley taunt. The classic stand tall one. And that's going to be the game. Oa already on match point. Not exactly the most surprising thing to see, but we'll see if KJ can at least take a game or maybe even bring it back. It could happen.
Just
And going back to the K rule for the last game, interesting choice.
We look a lot like that.
I think his goal is to just try and screw with KJ, not give him a chance to get a download on either character, and it's working so far. Already taking the first stock. Missing the confirm off of the crown, which is a bit strange. He's usually pretty good about confirming off it. Gets another crown hit. That finally gets a non-crown hit on this stock with the jab.
KJ
just desperately trying to find the stock. Back air does the trick. 30%. Pretty good place. Not in a terrible spot here. This is still very doable. Nice confirm. Oh, that's gonna hurt.
I don't think we started tying.
Really? Going for the down air to the trap. That's one I haven't seen before. Well, I guess I have seen him do that once, but it was to get a confirm into up smash. I don't know why he felt the need to do it at that percent and in that situation. Does trade, but still takes the stock, so it's still either player's game, and KJ cannot afford to lose this one. He wants to continue on. And that's it. Nothing else to really say. That's what we were expecting, and Oa delivered. Well, that's all for tonight. I might have to make an announcement to not mess with the headphone auxiliary cords, or maybe do it more subtly with electrical tape over that port. Either way, thanks for tuning in, folks. We'll see you all next week, most likely.
No, we just won.
If I lost,
I'd have a shot.